What up everyone, welcome back to the channel, and today we're going to be continuing the series again. So in the last video we saw how we can install Appium and Spectre, as well as set up the desired capabilities and save them. So we're just going to continue where we left off. So the reason why I said save the desired capabilities, so I'm just going to close this, and if you go under the save capabilities sets, so we call it pixel full caps, you can see it's already saved. So if we were to close Appium and restart it, all we have to do is come to our save capability sets and just click start session. All right, so you can see that it fired up the contacts application. So this is Appium Inspector. So what you can see is all the highlights. We have all the elements that are available. We can collect these elements, interact with these elements, and use it for our scripting. So let's take a look to the top. This is native app mode. We have a web hybrid app mode. So maybe if you had let's say a React Native app, maybe something would look a little different. Next we have select elements. So this is what's going to highlight the elements for us. So I'm just going to put it back to the native app mode because that's what we're using. Next we have tap by coordinates. So anytime I move my cursor, you can see in the top, in this area right here, we have the coordinates. So we can use this coordinates if we want to, you know, select on a particular area. So let's say we wanted to click right here, we can set that. This actually going to click it, so you can see everything loaded. It made the interaction on the emulator and it's captured here as well. So we're just going to click the cancel, and everything is working nice. So we're going to take a look at this. So take off the tap by coordinates and go back by select elements. Next we have back refresh. So if we were to close, let's say, this page on the emulator, see, it didn't refresh automatically. So what we can do is just hit the refresh button, and it's going to take a screenshot and capture that again for us. Next we have the start recording. But to start the recording, you're going to use the interactive tools here. So whether tap, send keys, clear, copy, well, you're not going to use copy attributes and get timing, so you're just going to use these three. So if you wanted to say click add account, we can put our focus on this element and then do tap. So now we can see one, our element is pulling up another page for us, the Google sign-in page. And next we can see the mobile element and how it's going to capture that element for us. Right now it's written in Java and JUnit, so it has it defined. So that's what we did. It found the element using the ID. So this is what it found the element using, this type of selector. And you can do this for others as well. So if I hit the refresh, we can see we are on this page. So right now I don't think I can interact with anything here, but I can't interact with the next. So if I hit tap next, we can see we have that element captured as well. So that's a little bit of the recording. I'm just going to close that. I'm just going to go back to the main app and go back and come back to the main contacts page, and let's rest refresh, and we're good. There's also some other languages. So we have JSWD Promise, JS WebDriver, Oxygen, JUnit Python, Ruby, and the robot framework. So if you're interested in using the record function, you can use that. And we have search for element. So you can search for element by ID. So certain selectors, you paste it in there and it would find it. So let's try that out. So if we go here, we have this ID. Let's copy it. And let's try moving our focus on something else, let's say the book. And if you do search for element by ID, let's paste, let's see what happens. So it brought back this. Let's see if we can tap the element. Yep, that worked. It put us back into, you know, the Google sign-in page. So that definitely works. So you can definitely find elements using that way. It's not something that you typically do. So let's cancel. Next we have copy XML source to clipboard. So if you want to copy everything that's in here, all this XML, you can do that as well. And you can just quit the session and close the inspector. So let me just put this back to Java JUnit. All right, so next, just gonna open this up a little bit bigger. So sometimes you may have some elements. Let's refresh. So there we go. I can interact with these elements. So that's, there we go. I thought we couldn't at first, but just refresh and all the elements are clearly you can capture by XPath, all those. You can search by text, different attributes as well. So element ID, the index, where the package is at, what type of class, so that's a type of a button. The text, forget email. So different ways you can capture the element. I'm just gonna go back to the contacts page and do a quick refresh. And it's gonna bring us here. So what we're gonna do is just simply create a new contact. So in order to do that, we need to interact with this button. So right now it's not finding that button, and that's good. This is a good example on using your XML app source to find elements that are not being in focus. So right now I cannot focus on this floating button. So if I take a look into my app source, let's try to get a little bigger so we can see. I'm just going to open this up. There we go. So I'm just going to scroll. What you typically do, you would need to just open, make sure you can open up all the arrows. It's going to tell you where you're at. So what we're looking for is the floating. So here it is. Somehow it's this little blue rectangle, but this is the element we need to interact with, the floating action button. And to know that we're interacting with it, we can hit the tab button, and this should take us to a new page. So here we are. We have a create a new contact, so we can interact with each of these elements as well. If the cancel button, you have to create new contact title, save. Right now I'm just going to enter my name, enter a dummy text phone number, and click save. I'm just gonna show you that we can either record it and just save that as well, or we can just to close the record, you can click close to open it back up. Here we go. So I hit declare actions, and I'm just going to hit type my first name, type my last name, type the phone number, and then click save. I'm just going to record that. So first thing is first, we're going to click this element. We're going to use the tap. Now we have the focus of the cursors in the first name. Now we want to send the key so we can use this button. Next, I'm going to type Jamal. Hit the send keys. So now we see the first name is entered. So now we're going to go to the last name element. We selected it. It's in focus. Now we have to tap that. Now you can put the cursor in focus. You see it in focus over here. And now we're going to do send keys. And we're going to do Richard. Hit the send keys. And now we have our last name. And the last thing we're going to do is the phone. So we have that in focus, hit tap, and we're going to do send keys. So we can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 5, 9, 8, 7, 6. Don't call me. So now we can see we have the number inserted as well. And what we want to do is simply just click the save button. So we're gonna put that in focus, and we're gonna click the tap. All right, it looks a little weird here. That means a screenshot captured before it fully loaded. All we have to do is just hit the refresh button, and everything should look good. So now I have a new contact myself, Jamal. Everything is in here. So that's pretty much how you can get familiar with Appium and Appium Inspector. Some could take this code, we can input this code into Java and run the script via that. I will do another video showing how you can use Java to interact with Appium and run it as a script. We may do the same test case and just do it in Java. If you guys found this video helpful, definitely smash the like button, subscribe to the channel. If you have any questions, feel free to drop a comment, reach out to me, and I'll do my best to respond as quickly as I can. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in another video.